5 seconds to go. Start. Today, there are hundreds of ISKCON temples in different countries of the world, and a number of gurukuls are keeping Indian culture alive. ISKCON has told the world that faith for India means zeal, enthusiasm, and gaiety, and faith in humanity. Today, people in different countries of the world are often seen doing kirtan in Indian attire. The clothes are simple. There are instruments like dholak and manjira in their hands, and they chant Hare Krishna, swaying in a spiritual peace. When people see them, they think that maybe there is some festival or event. But this kirtan, this event, is a way of life for us in our country. This joyful form of faith has been attracting people all over the world and is giving new hope to the stressed world today. Friends, Lord Krishna has said in the Gita, that is, one who loves only the living entity has compassion and love for them, does not hate anyone. He is endearing to God. This mantra has been the basis of the thought of India for thousands of years. And our temples have been involved in giving social basis to this thinking. ISKCON temples have emerged as the modern centers of this tradition of service. I remember how ISKCON had stepped forward to serve the people when there was an earthquake in Kutch. Whenever there has been any calamity in the country, whether it is the tragedy of Uttarakhand or the devastation of cyclones in Odisha and Bengal, ISKCON has always lent its support to the society. Even in the corona pandemic, you have been continuously arranging food and other requirements for millions of patients, their families, and migrants. Apart from the pandemic, you continue the relentless campaign of providing free food and service to millions of poor. I am aware of the hospitals being built by ISKCON for COVID patients and how you are participating in the vaccine campaign. I wish ISKCON and all its devotees very best for this service. Friends, today you are not only serving Krishna with the mantra of Satya, Seva and Sadhana, but also playing the role of brand ambassador of Indian ideals and values all over the world. The eternal ethos of India is, may all be prosperous and happy, may all be free from illness. This idea has become the resolution of millions of people today through ISKCON. The love for God and the vision of God in the living entity alone is the way to the realization of this resolution. This is the path God has shown us in the Vibhuti Yoga chapter. We are hopeful that we will apply this mantra of God is everywhere in our life and make human beings aware of this harmony. With this spirit, thank you all so much. Hare Krishna. Stop.